to do, our intention today is to do this video to remote view events that are going to happen in October. TeaCup has a couple of questions, you know, kind of, she pretty much has the outline that we're going to go with. And the Oracle of Delta, she will give us her impressions of what might be happening. And I will be doing an intuitive channeling for what I think might be happening. We'll see how it goes. And if we're just going to share this, then you will. Then it worked out pretty good. Okay, go ahead, Teacup, and, you know, get us started.
Okay, good afternoon, unlikely channeler. I usually call you T. Good afternoon. Yeah. Oracle at Delta, good afternoon. Can Hello. We see if you come through?
Hello from the sacred space in the mountains of the Rocky Mountains.
Okay. Okay. So the reason why I decided to get a hold of T today was so we could go over some events that I think we should address, and I wanted to get the input from us three, whether it be intuitive, whether it be just off the cuff, maybe some news related, but that was my intention.
Okay.
So I had put together an outline today, and I got together with everybody, and we decided that I was just going to spontaneously go over the things that I had put down on our list. So maybe we could get maybe a truer reading or outlay of what is going to be going on, or what I perceive is going on. I have not put down my personal thoughts on this, but what I did do is I did an outline. So we will take time to go through everybody's, or if somebody has something, just you know, let's just start talking about it.
Okay, so, sounds good. And just before you go on, I apologize, but we're going to have to do it in a couple of different sessions.
Okay.
Yes. I think this one, let's go for 20 minutes because... let's just go for 20 minutes and then we'll pick up again. Okay.
Oracle, is that okay with you?
Yes, definitely preferred.
Okay. Okay. Sounds good. Go ahead. Sorry.
Okay. So as we are aware, today is October 2nd, 2023. It is on a Monday. And there is I'm going to read the words exactly. There is a nationwide alert test coming on Wednesday. Oracle, were you aware that this is going to be happening?
Not on the physical plane, but I've gotten some other previous warnings, I guess.
Okay.
That expect an emergency broadcast from the voice spaces.
Okay. All right.
That's very interesting. Very interesting.
Okay. So, how can you hear Oracle T?
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah.
Okay. All right. So what this is there is going to be a national wide alert test on Wednesday, October 4th. It will be at 2:20 PM Eastern Standard Time.
That's perfect. Wow.
So this is an article from Yahoo that I pulled up, and I'm gonna read it, and then this is where we're gonna start. I got this article from Friday, September 29th, 2023. The federal government will conduct a nationwide alert test on Wednesday, October 4th. The Federal Emergency Management Agency, FEMA, and the Federal Communications Commission's FCC will send out notifications to cell phones, as well as radios and TVs, to test the National Wireless Emergency Alert System. I've never heard it that way, but that's the way this says. So they're going to test the National Wireless Emergency Alert System and ensure the system, in parentheses, includes the public's familiarity with it, parentheses, is ready for a real crisis. The cell phone portion of the test will assess the wireless emergency alerts, the WEAs, nationwide. That is a new one. I've never heard that one. If you live near a decent-sized metro area, there's a solid chance that you've received the Amber Alerts. So we're all aware of Amber Alerts. And it can also broadcast signals for intimate threats, public safety, and presidential notices in a national emergency.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. The test WEA portion will use FEMA's Integrated Public Alert and Warning System. It's called IPAWS, a centralized internet-based system that can broadcast emergency notifications through various communications networks. If your cell phone is set to English, you'll receive a message at around 2:20 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, reading, "This is a test of the National Wireless Emergency Alert System. No action is needed." Those with phones in Spanish, I won't go through that because I can't. Of course, the message will be accompanied by a unique tone and vibration based on the past tests we've received, and could easily be described as a jarring and obnoxious alarm that will immediately make you stop what you're doing, utter select obscenities, and pick up your phone to make it stop. Using the Emergency Alert System, EAS, the television and radio portion of the assessment is scheduled to happen simultaneously. This will be the seventh nationwide EAS test. The cell phone part of the test is scheduled to last about 30 minutes, but you should be able to dismiss the notification and shut up your phone as soon as you see it and hear it. Last sentence. And in the parentheses, extremely unlikely, close parentheses, event of an actual emergency on Wednesday, the test will take place a week later on the back date of October 11th. Okay, so
the event that nothing happens on the 4th.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You've got a backup plan. Okay.
Okay. So, I mean, I go, why didn't we use this in Maui? But hey, you know what? What am I thinking?
You know, they did have a nice little fake emergency in Hawaii. What about beginning of COVID? Remember when there was someone else that triggered the alarm in Hawaii?
Yep, there was a tsunami warning.
Yep.
Oh, mm-hmm. Okay.
Everybody ran.
Okay. So there was a couple of things that I found was interesting. Prepare for the jarring noise. Okay, I've heard several things on this. I'm going to go over that in a minute. I didn't know FEMA was involved. I found that interesting. Okay, that was my first interest. I also they have renamed quite a bit of stuff, which now I'd like to go in and really look to see really what we've just signed on to, all of us, unknowingly and unwittingly. And the other thing that I found it's the frequency. Let's see where I'm looking. I'm looking at my notes. The tone.
Deep tone.
Mm-hmm.
And the and the vibration and a jarring noise.
Yes. So, but let me. I. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Unique.
And let's all remember that any type of frequency it manifests as sound in the way that we would perceive it.
Correct.
And frequencies can be a whole range of things.
And I mm-hmm. found that very telling when they said unique tone and yeah. vibration. Yeah. Because when they start using vibrations,
mm-hmm.
literally they can set us up that if you have your cell phone and or any device by your bed, they can put in frequencies and vibrations through your phone, and eventually they're putting through subliminal messages and subliminal things that you can wake up at night and you'll answer your phone and you didn't even
be triggered. And be in there now.
There you go. Yeah, you're triggered. And yeah,
This is what I find interesting. I believe that this is more of a disclosure than it is an actual thing happening, because this has been going on for quite some time. So when you look at this, this is more like to the public's, to those that are awake and paying attention, such as you, who read the article and is interested in, you know, actual relevant information, you'll find that this is a disclosure rather than it is an actual event. And that is in order to provide the information for the awake individual to take, withdraw consent from this program and take back their own power when they realize that their sovereignty has been completely violated in every conceivable way, when our personal space and personal property is simply a tool for the machinations of whomever may be in charge.
That's the new word is for the deletes, not the elites. It's for the deletes. We now need to call them the deletes. I also, so that was very, and very, it prompted me to get a hold of everybody. The test is going to last 30 minutes. Oh, go ahead. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, at the test, I wanted to make a comment on what Oracle of Delta said. When she said that, and I think it absolutely makes so much sense. When she said that, I saw two branches, you know. One is that sovereignty branch. Those who are aware will think sovereignty. We'll say disclosure, this is our sovereignty coming forward. Then the other branch is the fear that I think is intentional by the controllers, the evil controllers, whatever they're called.
Well said.
Does that sound right, Oracle?
Well said, very well said. Including TeaCup, wasn't it on the, so I spoke with you about fourth, didn't I?
Did you speak with me about the fourth? Yes, I believe so. Yes.
Remember what I said was happening?
Please remind me.
Okay, so my belief system, after looking at the various parts of the narrative playing out in front of us, a major bifurcation event, as major as 2017. So this is going to be that exactly what Unlikely Chandler just said. It's going to be two branches of reality siphoning off.
That is part of my other notes. Okay. And then, okay. So, that was a good branch analogy. that I don't know if you heard Oracle was humming, I mean, going, I mean, you know, I don't know if you heard that, but it is, I think there's a lot of going on amongst us three because of just, but like I said, I think with us three together, we can start breaking this down and start, I think, projecting and really coming up with what we think's going on. This is the other thing, and I put it in red on my notes. It says, in the extremely unlikely event of an actual emergency on Wednesday, the test will take place a week later on the backup date of October 11th. So when, how are we going to have a backup on October 11th when they've already put out an EMP then?
Well, that's disclosure.
Okay.
Yes, I believe it'll be much more of a disclosure event rather than a literal frequency sent out. However, don't think that those that are not, that have not done their clearing and done their work and student's awakening process, if anyone that may be dissonant still has the ability to be triggered into whatever program they decide to put you in. Therefore, you will start seeing aliens in the sky or nuclear bombs going off right next to you when the person that has taken the time to do their work will not see what you see, because there is a difference in perception when one has authority over their own life.
Interesting.
Absolutely. I absolutely think that is completely right on. Because of that boom event transmission I had, it's that kind of thing. It's the person, it's not everybody. I mean, it's not the populace. The boom is called a boom because it's a boom to the human. It's the person. I mean,
individual.
You're not familiar with what's going on, but you see it. I mean, it happens, and to you, it's a boom. That you see what, like she said, the alien or the a nuclear bomb, you know, just because that's what we are familiar with. We're familiar with those words. Say that again.
Yeah.
And have been programmed to expect nuclear bombs and aliens.
Exactly.
And right. And see, and neither one of those do I believe that is there. I believe that it's, I know this is going to sound a little bit different, but I believe that the frequency and the tone, the unique tone and frequency, the unique tone and vibration,
right.
What I see is that is the way that they are going to send out a frequency to see as a test trial to see who they can knock out. I believe that the knockout is going to be the first of knockouts for the people that have gone on and gone against their really sovereign self and have taken on the deletes concept of this situation that we've been living in the last 3 years. I was sitting and I was reading to my son this same article that I read to you guys. And he said that it's to activate the bifrequency. Uh-huh. And he said, we won't have to worry about that. And I said, and I looked at him and he goes, because we've chosen to keep our sovereign self, because of the last 3 years, we have steadfastly stayed and said, we are not. He said that frequency is to activate the people that have decided to get the things that they feel that they needed to get the last 3 years. And the people are going to start losing it. He says they are going to turn into necromorphs.
Okay, so well said. I agree with that because I believe that there's almost a artificial noding, a node system, where an individual becomes the satellite, I guess you could say, to pull in some sort of other demonic. I mean, even though it's technology, I think that there's very much a demonic aspect to it all, in which their bodies will be possessed in all likelihood, which will either devolve them to the point where they're zombie-esque, or they will go into this state of a fugue state where they're not even in control of what they're doing.
It's undead. He said it's an undead state.
Yeah. I'm going to have to stop this. Can okay. we pick up in a few minutes?
Okay, hold on. We need to close out here. Okay, we'll pick up right there. Oracle, she's going to.